So today we'd be exploring how to create a flowchart or information architecture or, you know, a user journey map in the Chat GPT, and we'd be seeing, you know, how to do it very quickly. Hey, what's up, guys? Recently, we have been seeing there is, you know, a lot of noise about AI in the industry, and especially in the creative industry. And yes, definitely AI is going to, you know, grow a lot in the industry, but definitely be assured that it is not going to replace the humans. But yes, you need to master how to do your work, you know, or how to get your job done quickly than others who are, you know, in the market, because using AI you can do, you know, hours of job in minutes or seconds, you can say. You know, so just to get started with it, just click on, you know, explore GPTs, where you can see lots of different options, you know, different applications which you can embed or, you know, you can talk with the different applications and create whatever you want. So definitely there are lots and lots of tools. So today we'd be, you know, talking about this Whimsical's diagram, so which, you know, I had recently used. It is a very good you know, tool or add-on, you can say, for the Chat GPT. So I'll share the link in the description or, you know, the name of this tool in the description. So you just have to, you know, click on start chat. It will open a chat window, and now you have to, you know, add your prompt. So it'd be, you know, adding a prompt here. I'll be just pasting it, and then I'll explain you, you know, what this prompt is about. So this prompt is basically about, you know, creating a user journey map for a movie ticket booking platform. Let me just zoom in a little bit so you can read the prompt clearly. If you basically focus the prompt, you know, how we are starting, you know, we are asking GPT to, you know, work as a senior or a lead UX designer to, you know, design a movie ticket booking platform, and where, you know, we'd be creating a user flow for the same application, where, you know, how a user will come to the application and book the movie tickets, right? And apart from this, we are also, you know, letting the GPT know that, okay, apart from this, we want users to, you know, able to select the theater or, you know, select the movie which they want to book. Also, we want them to, you know, ability to watch the trailer or, you know, check out the reviews before booking the tickets. And also, you know, we are asking it to give the ability to basically, you know, schedule a cab in advance, you know, for the movie. So if you notice the prompt, basically, you know, we have different parts in this prompt, and you know, most of the times, you know, people say, okay, we have explored ChatGPT, we have explored other AI tools, but we are not getting the results which we should be. So, you know, it is completely depending on what is your prompt and how you are giving the instructions to the any AI tool. You know, it basically only works whatever instructions you give. It will not add anything from himself, itself, you know. It will only follow the instructions which are given by you. So it is not a human brain, it is still artificial intelligence. So you have to use your brains to, you know, get your job done. Definitely we'll be covering in a separate video how to write better prompts that will, you know, make your job much easier. So till then, I'll, you know, paste this prompt in the description of the video. So let me quickly you know, hit the send button or, you know, generate button. So now you can see it will basically create a mermaid code, which you can, you know, simply copy and go to the mermaid as well, where you can, you know, simply use the same code generated by GPT to create your visual representation of the same code if you are using GPT 3.5. And if you're using GPT 4, then you know, it will directly give you the code in this, you know, Whimsical diagrams itself. So you just have to click on allow. So now it will, you know, interact with the tool. So now you can see, you know, the diagram has been generated, and now you can take a screenshot of this. You can take, you know, copy this image, get it in the Figma, right, and then paste it, and then you can quickly take a look at here. Okay, it says, you know, start, then select the movie or theater. If we say select movie, then it will show us the movie details. Then it will have two options: watch trailer or read reviews. Both of them will take to the process to booking. Select the showtime, choose the seats, choose the payment method, pay on the app or pay at the counter, schedule the cab, and then confirm the booking, review the confirmation, and then end of the flow. And if you go with the other route where, you know, user is selecting the theater first, then he's looking at the theater details, and then it is selecting the movie, and then, you know, probably, you know, this should be updated, and it should be, you know, go to the view movie details. But definitely we can manually make those changes, and we cannot, you know, directly rely on the AI, but it has given you, you know, most of the job done automatically. So you can use this and modify this further, and then, you know, represent it as your own version, rather than, you know, something, you know, directly creating something on the ChatGPT or any other AI tool and share it as it is. Because, you know, if you are doing that, then anybody can easily understand, okay, it is generated by the AI, or anyone else can do it, obviously, you know, without your help. So if you are a designer, then you have to add your flavor to it. So you just have to use the tools wisely. Get, you know, most of it, you can say almost, you know, 60-70% from the AI, and then, you know, 30-35% you have to use your designer's, you know, creativity, designer freedom, or you can say, you know, the experience which you have, and based on that you can create, you know, the same piece of work. So I would, you know, modify this a little, and then I can present this to the stakeholders, and, you know, probably get it approved, or, you know, you can have your first draft quickly, you know, done within the minutes, right? So it is just, you know, the time which you have to write the prompt, and then everything is real fast. So definitely, you know, stay tuned for the next video, where we would be discussing about, you know, how to write better prompts to get the job done. Till then, yes, keep watching, keep learning, keep designing.